There is something to worry about when you're down the hole. If one of these big rocks fell down and crushed this dead cord,
they might find your earplugs. That'd be about it.
Yeah.
Bushman Rod Manning and explosives expert Brad O'Brien are attempting to blast through an impenetrable layer of rock as a favour to claim owner Martin Hutchison.
This is the mat off the drill. I reckon it'll do as a blast mat.
To stop flying debris, the 300-kilogram rubber mat must be carefully positioned over the hole whilst still allowing the detonation cord to be ignited.
So we've got the blast mat on now. We've got all the explosives set.
I think we're good to go, mate. Fire in the hole.
Here we go. This is a good bit.
Three, two, one.
She's not going off. Well, Jesus Christ!
Well, she's not going off, mate. They go off enough for you? I got a funny feeling we might have opened up that hole for you, brother.
Well done.
More than welcome, mate.
Well done.
More than welcome. Yeah, I reckon that might nearly do.
That's done it. This is what you want. Just all blown to rubble. Well, thanks for doing that, Brad.
No, you're quite welcome, mate. No worries. Enjoyed it.
That's good, because I got another problem, mate.
You always got bloody problems.
I know I have. Friggin' old Les Erdy's back. And I can't mine on my own, so you're not doing anything for the next couple of days? You want to have a crack?
Mate, I was going shooting goat for the freezer,
well,
to be honest with you. Yeah, on the subject of old goats, if Les has hurt himself,
yeah.
I'll stick around. Why not?
Excellent, mate.
Involved blowing anything up?
No, you're not blowing anything up.
Can I break something?
I'm pretty good at that, mate, I can tell you.
Brad brings 16 years' experience working coal and gold mines.
I know that Rod's in a bit of strife, losing one hand down, so I don't mind helping out either. It's something new. I've never been open mining before, so it'll be a good experience, I reckon.
Righto, mate, just come down when I get to the bottom.
Righto.
Well, I can't expect him to do it for nothing, so I've got to slip him 10%. Which puts a lot more pressure on me and Les, because that 10% comes out of mine and Les's share, not the other side. So it's a bit more incentive to dig a bit harder, I guess.
You all good? Hello?
With ploughboys, you know, the money's come out in the dead line. It's right up against the face where I want to go into. Well, this is it, mate. This is where we're going to make our fortune.
Awesome.
Just with this here, mate, I've got a bad bit of faulting in the roof here. You can see the separation. Your best opal's nearly always found in real dangerous grounds, because of the faulting, that's what brings you opal. I don't think anything will come down, but sections like that, you might just get a rock come loose. That's why I've got so many props just in this little section.
Oh, fair enough. It looks pretty hectic, doesn't it?
That's where the opal is, you know, that's where I've got to go. Well, I've got a couple of matches. I'm thinking of just putting them up in here. If it does start to separate, we're going to see it. If I can get that just in the crack, so that the match is only just sitting there, right? It's only just there. Now, if that starts to open, the matches will fall out.
I like that. Yeah, that's good.
It saved me more than once, I can tell you. I just got to find another. There, yeah, that's a good spot there. Righto, now they're only just sitting there, right? Just keep glancing at them every now and again. If they fall, let me know.
Yeah, righto. Awesome.
Righto, here we go.
I was preparing my best girly scream too.
What do you reckon? I think it'll be all right. Just stay over there a bit.
Yeah, mate.
We got 40 foot of sandstone, dirt and rocks above us. It's a lot of weight. We're taking a big area out where the tons are faulting. It's a gamble, but I reckon I got an 80% chance of pulling it off. 20% kill myself, 80% make some money. If something does go wrong, dig me out.
A little bit unnerving to see it all as bare rock.
This might take a bit of getting used to.
With Les recovering from a back injury, Rod Manning and first-time Opal miner Brad O'Brien are following the Opal run.
How's she looking, Brad?
Oh, your match sticks are still there, mate.
Under the most unstable section of roof in Ploughboys.
With the old fella being off with a crooked back, it'd be nice to show him a handful of good colour, wouldn't it, you know? It'd help his back heal a lot, I reckon.
Kind of drizzling rocks with a chance of boulders, isn't it?
It's a bit like that. Oh, no, just be a little bit wary. One of my matches has fallen out, so there is a little bit of movement there.
What do you reckon?
Well, I'm not particularly liking what I'm seeing. Oh! Nah.
No, that's grumios.
What can we do, Brad? I think I'll back and drop it, mate.
That could be the best idea. That's really grummy. That's ready to let go. When it's nice and solid, doesn't make a sound, but when you get a little bit of a gap between the rock plates, it sounds like a drum, hollow, and all that lot there is just sitting there ready to come down. So he'll pull back and give it a bit of a tickle, and hopefully it releases back to hard rock.
It might just come down in little pieces, or we may have a big fall, so we'll just see what happens, I guess.
Copy that. My hat's upstairs, you can have that. If not, I'll meet you at the pub at 4 o'clock.
Aye, mate. Got to move forward to get the worst of it, I think.
It's looking ready to go. If you can get it up in here somewhere, that might peel the whole lot out for you.
Yeah, so I can't quite reach it.
The digger arm only has a reach of 3 metres and needs to be constantly repositioned.
I'm going to move forward a little bit, right into the danger zone. Righto, here we go.
I think I might have just eaten the underwear. Oh!
I've got to keep moving forward.
Rod and temporary mining partner Brad are struggling to bring down tons of unstable rock. With 10 metres of earth above them, a collapse would likely kill them.
This next move, that's when she'll come down.
Bloody hell, mate.
That would have given you a headache, Brad.
I reckon that might, absolutely. I'd much rather see it on the floor than coming at
that me. That would have come on us, for sure.
You get a ton and a half on top of your helmet, it ain't gonna hold up. It ain't gonna work.
Geez, that's starting to look good off there.
That is starting to look all right. Whoa, hang on. I reckon you got a bit of rainbow in there. A bit of colour there on the ground, mate. I reckon
hang on, lift my arm out of the way.
Got it. I reckon you just knocked some rainbow out.
Oh, look at that, mate.
Oh, that is brilliant.
All the way around.
Holy.
It's everywhere.
That's awesome.
Oh,
I like that. Ooh. Look at the purple running through it.
Look at the red. Oh, mate.
That is real lightning in the rock. I'm going to call you lightning rod now. You're finding the colour.
Look at that. A seam on that, beautiful seam.
All out of one tooth, one bite.
Oh,
that's like curves.
Jesus, I can't wait to show old Les this.
Absolutely gorgeous.
There's some more. We got a lot of money there.
But well, looking at that bucket, it makes it all worthwhile coming down here.
Yeah, you're not wrong, mate.
That's phenomenal.
Let's go and show Les. This is going to straighten his back up.
Rod and Brad have found seam opal, featuring the full spectrum of colours. It's in the rough, and there's 200 grams.